So there's only 118 elements known to man. We actually know very little about the basic building blocks that make up this universe.
Every time we make a new element, we are probing a specific number of protons and neutrons that can exist in the universe.
So when we make a theory that makes some prediction about how nuclei should bind together, these still have a lot of unknowns. Making a new element is a way to push this boundary of knowledge further, and then we can constrain our theories and get way more accurate on how these predictions are going to be done in the future.
There's also this area, as you add more and more protons and neutrons together, this thing called the island of stability, that maybe you can add enough together that you can get stable elements again. As we try to make new elements, we're getting closer and closer to that region. And so we might be able to elucidate some information about what is going on in these really heavy, really exotic systems.
So in this element 116 experiment, we combined titanium 50 with plutonium 244 in a fusion reaction. So something like 6 trillion ions of titanium 50 per second impinged on a stationary target of 244 plutonium. And once every couple of weeks, we expect a complete fusion to survive long enough to enter the BGS and to be detected with our detector. So that's how we made the 290 Livermorium. And element 120 will be very similar, except it'll be a titanium 50 beam plus a californium 249.
So in practice, making a superheavy element should be pretty easy. You just take two smaller elements and you collide them together with a lot of energy and hope that they fuse into the element that you want. Unfortunately, in practice, it's actually very hard. So we have to use a lot of fancy machinery and equipment to separate out this very rare event from all of the other junk that we don't want.
I mean, it's a new experiment. It's something that no one's done before. So that's sort of the exciting part about doing this type of experiment. We don't know how long it's going to take. We don't know what exactly the properties are of the element that we produce, what it's going to be.
Probably most people have come across the periodic table sometime in their high school years, and we all remember that it has 7 rows. Well, this new element is going to be on the 8th row of the periodic table. To think in high school that, you know, you can actually add more rows to the periodic table, it's pretty exciting.